And on this Thanksgiving, let's hear a story of gratitude and the power of community. Gardner Waldeyer produces videos for YouTube, and he's grateful for his friends and his neighbors. They're helping him raise the frame of a house he's building out of the trees on his property in Maine. Jon Kalish reports.
Gardner Waldeyer lives in Waterford, Maine. 1,000 subscribers to his YouTube channel know him as Bus Huxley. The lanky 35-year-old makes his living as a cook, builder, and doer of odd jobs. He's done 35 episodes so far in a series titled A House from Trees, which chronicles him harvesting the forest on his property and building a timber frame house.
So I'm going to try to get this enormous log right here. I'm going to try to get that onto the trailer. We'll see if that works.
In October, Waldeyer put the word out that he'd be raising the frame of the house in early November. Family, friends, and neighbors gathered in the frigid Saturday morning air near a table laid out with hot coffee and homemade scones baked by Waldeyer's partner, Sarah. Some drove several hours to help out. Luke Stone runs a wedding catering company in Vermont. He came to cook for the volunteers.
When I pulled in, I figured there'd be four people here trying to put something together, and I may even be needed to help, but I show up and there's 30 cars here.
Ethan Hipple drove 90 minutes from Portland with his wife Sarah and their two teenagers. Hipple and Waldeyer once worked together at a state park in New Hampshire.
Biggest fans. I'd say we're probably the biggest fans.
Oh, yeah.
I've seen every video multiple times.
In addition to his series, A House from Trees, Waldeyer's YouTube channel features videos on cooking, animals, and auto mechanics. Paul Houseman lives in the nearby town of Albany, Maine. Houseman traded Waldeyer some fabric that prevents water from seeping up in a driveway for a cutting board made of locust wood featured in one of Waldeyer's videos.
He's a Renaissance man, as they say. Gardner's kind of a local legend around here. So,
what this Renaissance man was up to on this particular day amounted to solving a puzzle involving four wooden structures that weighed 2,000 pounds each. A crane used thick nylon bands to pull the U-shaped pieces known as bents upright as four men screwed supports into them. The timbers used for the frame were heavy, and each was 8 inches by 8 inches. Waldeyer managed to move them around on sawhorses by himself as he cut tendons. But on the day the frame was raised, he let Matt Burke run the show. Every Friday, Burke has his morning coffee while watching the latest Bus Huxley video. Burke built dozens of timber frame homes with his father.
My dad used to raise them without a crane at all. It would go up by manpower and pike poles and block and tackle if you could find something to hook it to. So we'd have raisings like this.
Raisings like this because there were so many people helping, even with the crane doing much of the heavy lifting.
If it were at anybody else's location, Gardner would be one of the first guys to show up.
That's neighbor Jeff Winslow.
It was kind of like a old-fashioned barn raising, a community event. You don't see that just everywhere today.
At the end of the day, the volunteers gathered around a bonfire and feasted on spare ribs cooked by the wedding caterer, Luke Stone. Standing in the glow, Waldeyer was clearly pleased with the two-story house frame awaiting walls, floors, and a roof.
Here it is. It's a big square pile of timber now, and it's up high. Oh, my goodness. It's something.
Gardner Waldeyer hopes to have a roof on his house before December rolls around. He expects he'll produce videos on this house built from trees for another couple of years. For Here and Now, I'm Jon Kalish in Waterford, Maine.
And stay with us. We've got a lot more Here and Now.